Hi everyone, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. Let's continue the January 2026 Technic reviews with a very exciting set, and no, it's not a car this time. It's the 42221 NASA Artemis Space Launch System Rocket. As I mentioned in the preview, back in September in Billund at Fan Media Days, I had the chance to talk to the designer of this set, the legendary Ola Kroigo. He joined the Technic team in 1987 and designed fan favorites like the Big Red behind me, as well as many other great sets. I will do my best to include everything I heard from him in the video. The Space Sub team returns to Technic next year, which is quite interesting. On the front of the box we see the rocket and a sneak peek of its main function. The back shows the three stages of the launch sequence, the four microfigures, and the workings of the base. Let's open it up. The set has 632 pieces, costs 60 euros or dollars, and launches on the 1st of January 2026, and pre-orders are already available in some countries, check the link below. Inside we get 7 numbered bags, some loose parts, the sticker sheet and the manual. Unfortunately, there's only one extra page with images. It would have been nice to see more about the Artemis and the development of the LEGO model. Here's the part list if you are interested. Now let's start building. We begin with the base, which is quite colorful at first. The early gears appear, but at this point it's still not entirely clean what they will drive. By the end of bag 1, we get to test the sound generator. Yes, this set has a clever little mechanical sound system built in. When you rotate the crank, the force passes through these gears regardless of the direction. This one gear handles the noise, it stays silent in descent mode but creates this sound in takeoff mode. The trick is this black friction pin. In one direction it creates enough resistance to lift the gear and its support piece, producing the sound. Replace it with a grey frictionless pin and the system becomes silent. A simple but brilliant function, I love it. Next, we use the large frames to build a support tower, including the mount for the arms. We add various covers to the base, connect the crank to the gears, and the driving mechanism is now complete. The first sticker goes on the panel, and the structure includes some strategically placed studded bricks. Then we build the openable lid. After that, it is time to reveal one of the new parts that was made for this large screw element, which originally came from City. It had a studded block that was also used in the retro radio, for example, but as the designer said, that version was not suitable for Technic builds. So this new version was created with pin and axle holes, making it a better fit for Technic. This element becomes a key part of the main mechanism, although it still needs a few more parts for proper alignment. In phase 5, we build the main rocket itself. There are a few Technic elements here that are new in dark orange. The support arms are added next, and you can see an interesting solution used to secure that angled beam. At the bottom, those green rods are used to support the system elements. The rocket is mounted onto the new part and secured from both sides. Then we get two 32 module long axles. They are not new, but they are surprisingly rare in Technic sets. We also see links borrowed from train sets, followed by another new element, a cylindrical piece with an axle hole in the center and two pinholes on the sides. Its diameter matches 2x2 round system elements, so this will definitely be a useful part going forward. The boosters are assembled in sections, and at the top we get this printed comb piece. And then comes the tricky part, aligning stickers with holes. If you're wondering, no, I don't have good news, the white on the stickers is still noticeably brighter than the bricks. Each booster gets a beam, which is how they attach to the support arms. With the boosters finished, it's time to extend the upper section. This frame supports the final stage. A rope is attached and secured, then connected to a chain. Don't worry, this will all make sense very soon. There's also some clever system trickery here. A lightsaber hilt is used inside the cone to create a stud connection for the small dish. Now for the final assembly. The axles slide into place, then we add the part originally designed to manage motor cables. Here it guides the rope, and the chain is connected as well. Two half pins go into the corners, and finally we add the astronaut microfigures. Originally the set only included 2, but NASA requested 4, which is the standard crew size for this mission, so you can display them in several ways. And with that, the set is finished. In this configuration, the rocket stands about 47 cm tall, and when fully extended, it reaches roughly 71 cm. As a Technic model of the Artemis SLS, it looks fine, but honestly, this set isn't really about looks, it's about this. The launch function works extremely smoothly. That friction pin isn't just responsible for the sound, it also helps hold the rocket in position so it doesn't drop on its own. There's no traditional worm gear here. As you can see, the rope and chain work together to lift the upper stage. The chain adds weight, which prevents the mechanism from getting stuck on the way down. It is a very well thought out system and a great example of what LEGO Technic does best. I do have a small concern with the branding. The Artemis SLS isn't exactly the most successful or popular milestone in NASA's history, so some negativity around that is probably unavoidable. I've also seen complaints about realism. The boosters don't separate immediately and neither does the upper stage, but honestly, this is a toy for kids, not a fully accurate educational model. What really matters here is the amount of motion, the mechanical complexity, and how much there is to explore. Kids can study how everything works, while still having a very cool rocket launching playset. For 60 euros or dollars, this offers far more real Technic value than most small-scale supercars, even if I suspect it won't be as popular. And that's a shame. Maybe times are changing, and classic Technic is slowly fading away, but I really like sets like this, and I'm glad LEGO is still making them, branding and all. And realistically, you won't even have to pay for retail. This will likely drop below 50 euros at most retailers already at the start, which makes it a genuinely great deal. So folks, let me know what you think about the set, the build, the functionality. Let's talk about it in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe with notifications, as more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye.